Hello guys, welcome to Amit Thinks. In this video we will see how to set up Java on VS Code. For that, in the first step we will install the current Java version. In the second step we will install VS Code, and in the third step we will connect both Java and VS Code. In the last step we will run a sample Java program on VS Code. Let's see how to install the current Java version on Windows 11. Go to the web browser, type Oracle Java, press enter, click on the first link, oracle.com/java. Here it is. Click download Java. Here are the versions. The current one is the following. Go below, click Windows. Here I'll go for the exe file. Here it is. Click on it. Now the download started. Let's wait. We have downloaded the exe file. Right click and click open to begin the installation. Minimize. The setup started. Click next. The path is visible where Java will get installed. Not a problem, keep it as it is. Click next. Now the setup started. Let's wait. Successfully installed. Click close. Now let us go to the path. It was in C drive. Program files. Java. Double click. Bin. Under the bin, copy the path. Right click, copy, minimize, go to start, type environment variables, here click open, click environment variables, now go to path and double click here, under this click new, right click, paste, we have pasted the same path, after that click OK, OK. And the last OK. Now we have installed Java. Go to start, type cmd. Click open. Let us verify the installation. Type java space hyphen hyphen version and press enter. The version is visible. That means we successfully installed it. So guys, we successfully installed the current Java version. Now we will install VS Code. Let's start. At first, go to the web browser. On Google, type VS Code and press enter. Now the official website is visible, code.visualstudio.com. Click on it. Now here the version is visible, download for Windows. Click on it to download. Now the download started. Here it is. Here is the version. Right click and click open. To begin the installation, minimize. Now click I accept the agreement and click next. Here is the location where VS Code will get installed. Click next. It will create a start menu folder. Click next. Additional task, if you want a desktop icon, you can select this. But I don't need it. So I'll keep it as it is and click next. Now the summary is visible. Click install. Now the installation started. Let's wait. The VS Code setup completed. Click finish and it will launch on its own because the checkbox is by default clicked. I'll click finish. So VS Code opened for the first time. We successfully installed VS Code. Now let us connect Java with VS Code. For that, go to the web browser. Here type Java on VS Code and press enter. Click the first link, official. code.visualstudio.com and here is the link. Okay, go below. Here it's written install VS Code for Java. So click the following first one for Windows, coding pack for Java. Click on it. Now it will start downloading. After downloading the exe file, right click and click open, minimize. Okay, here it is, install coding pack for Java. These are the terms. Okay, now directly click next. Now it automatically detected that we have JDK 23 so that it can connect. Not a problem, click install. Now it is installing Java extensions for VS Code. We have completed the setup wizard. Click finish and it will launch VS Code on its own. Okay, or you can also go to start and type VS Code to open it on your own. But I'll just click finish. And we have reached VS Code. Now click here, click open folder, or you can directly click Java project. Okay, but I'll click open folder. Go to the desktop here and click new folder. And let's say I'll create a new folder with the name Amit project. Okay, double click and click select folder. Now here is your project. I'll right click and click new file. Let's say my first file would be demo and the extension for Java is .java. Here it is. Now let us run our first Java program. So this is our first Java program. Whatever I'll print inside this will get displayed. So I'll type Amit Diwan. Okay, that's it. Go to file, click save. I'll let you understand this later on. Now let us run it. So to ease your work, go to extensions, type code runner and press enter. Click on the code runner extension and install it. I've already installed it. That's why uninstall is visible. Here you just need to click install. After that, what will happen? It will ease your work. When you'll right click, it will directly show you run code. Okay, you can run it from here or you can also go to here, click terminal and click new terminal. So I hope you know how to run a Java program. First we compile it using Java C and the file name was demo, demo.java. Okay, press enter. Now we successfully compiled it and a class file got generated, right? Just like a simple Java program. Now run it Java space demo and press enter. So we printed Amit Diwan here. Okay, the same. Let us understand this code quickly. So this is a keyword class to define a new class. So our class name is demo and our file name was also demo. If you will keep different names, there will be an error. Here public is the access specifier. Static allows the main, that is the main function is here. This static will allow the main function to be called without the need to instantiate a particular instance. Void is the return type and main, it gets called when Java application begins. These are for command line arguments. You can check in a tutorial. The link is in the description. And the following line, system is a predefined class that provides
access. If you want a free Java tutorial,
out is the output stream and print ln will display the string. So after running your first Java program, refer the following link. Okay, this is our website. We will also mention this link in the video description. Okay, you can refer them. We just ran a first program. Thank you for watching the video.